Hello, my friends. Today we have the discussion about real reels, about Instagram strategy, about social media. And our guest today is Jonathan Howard. He's Instagram strategist and reels coach, or real reels coach. So Jonathan, please introduce yourself and let's continue with other questions about visibility, authenticity, and learn something about reels. So tell us more about what you do.
Awesome. Well, my name is Jonathan Howard, like you said, and I'm the owner of Success on Social. I help coaches create content so they can reach their ideal clients and make some money on social media, all the while showing up authentically with their videos, usually focusing on short form video and live video. So that's who I am. That's what I get to do. And that's what I enjoy doing with people. So there we go.
I absolutely love it because, you know, I remember our story, and if anybody want to hear the story, how Jonathan come from that very shy, antisocial guy with a hat on his eye, sitting like half way to the camera and hating all the way about videos when he actually joined my course Visibility Gym. If you want to hear the story, how he come all the journey from hating video, frankly speaking, towards teaching video and teaching things which he was some places contradicted in my course, and he was like, no, I will never do that. Now he's teaching it, and I'm very, very, very proud of you, Jonathan. And if you want to hear the story, please check the video somewhere in the corner. I will share the link. The video exists. So what I want to talk with you about today is not your journey previously, because I love the story before, but we discussed it for so many times. I think, you know, people can see the recording, but I want to talk about visibility, because I think for last couple of years, with all your progress, you start teaching people visibility and you show up very confidently, very strongly. So I want to hear your journey with reels specifically, because I remember we discussed at the beginning, you're like, I need to figure out reels. So they were just new by that time, and you're like, see, this is statistics. We discussed so many interesting stories. We by that time did run the marathon of reviewing people's social media profiles, and again I will give the link somewhere. So it was really interesting, because when we were reviewing people's profiles, we saw how people on Instagram acting in such a way that their social media pretty much doesn't bring them any clients. And then reels come and you become the star of reels. So please tell us more about visibility in this context.
I wish it just happened like that and I was the star of reels, because, you know, I was going through, and I told you that I needed to figure out reels because there was something, I just had a feeling about them. And obviously I had the right feeling, because they're now 80% of what people are doing on Instagram. So it's a huge part there. But I dove in and started to study reels and try to figure out why they were working for people and what was happening. And, you know, so I watched a lot of different strategists look at them, and I saw all the wrong things from a lot of those people. Because to me, I want to stand out on social media. I don't want to do the same thing everybody else is doing, because if I'm doing the same thing everybody else is doing, that's boring. That doesn't make me special. So I saw a lot of people telling people, you got to do the trends, you got to do this stuff. And I was like, that's not where I think people should be going. So as I was going through that, I discovered that I knew why they were going after the trends. That's where you got the tons of views. But that's not what people want. People want to be able to make money on social media. They want to be able to run their business and not have to worry about dancing and pointing and being silly. So I started to dance and point and be silly, but also teach lessons and try to get people to understand that you can just show up and talk to the camera and provide value. And that's enough for a reel. Because all it is a short form piece of video. It's 8 to 12 seconds.
Exactly. And I remember we discussed this interesting thing, because because you're an expert in branding and you're expert in social media, we can talk about the metrics, we can talk about the real deal, because we're not necessarily need to tell to people some polished data. This is not our style. You know, no polishing needed. So that is an interesting fact that at the beginning, when you were researching reels, how they work, we were talking about the fact of the return on investment. So we could see that how much time one reel takes, the idea, the production and all the kind of things, the investment of emotional expectations, dopamine, all the things. And then when you don't have this kind of feedback or you don't sell through it, so you basically just throw a lot of information and a lot of energy into it. And then when the feedback doesn't happen, it basically doesn't make any sense. So that was the meta of our discussion. So in terms of visibility, how did this part change? Because you touched very, very specifically. I remember you were standing on this like, okay, I am going to deliver value and I will see how to deliver it that people listen. So how do things change? What is that secret sauce which you found with this visibility aspect?
So there's so much that changed. Like, over the course of time, I learned how to create reels in a way that it only takes, and I actually teach now how to create reels in 15 minutes or less.
That's great.
And that means you're not spending an hour and a half doing it, just like with live video. So actually, one of my things that I do is I tell them that they need to learn how to do reels like it's live video.
Mm-hmm.
And they have three takes.
Visibility Gym is actually launching soon, so link will be below as well.
There you go. Yeah, take it. But it was one of those things, like, you have to do it in three takes, because if you're doing 25 takes, you're mm-hmm. going to end up burnt out.
Exactly.
And I very clearly remember there was a day kind of that started this where I was laying on the floor because I'd missed a transition. I was trying to do a transition because, you know, I had to make it flashy, and I missed and I fell, and it was like take number 25 of this reel, and I'm like, this isn't sustainable. There's no way I can do this, and there's no way that I can teach people to do this. So I started to figure out the ways to make it easier, and in making it easier, it was a lot more of, why am I doing a transition when movement is all I need? So why not walk and tell them a tip? So why not minimize and break it down to the basic stuff and get it out there so that people can do it? Because we don't need to do a transition. There's very few transitions happening on Instagram now. It's a lot of just, you got to keep moving. You got to keep them engaged. You got to be quick. You got to be smart about how you're doing it. But you don't need, you know, transition only adds that excitement that keeps them on for another 3 seconds. Mm-hmm. If you can get them that next 3 seconds in another way, get them in another way that's easier for you. So mm-hmm. I started to do a lot more focusing on that and focusing on the storytelling, because stories keep people's attention as well.
I admire the fact that you start thinking as director, not like a flashy kind of unprofessional person, because you had already professional background for this. You understand how video works. You understand how photography works because you have amazing photography and all of the things. So you understand the idea of how to be an art director and think as an art director rather than just like, you know, click for click, do real for unreal or whatever, you know, so that's really a good take, a very, very professional approach. I really, really love it. And personally, I mean, I didn't do any single reels. So today we're going to learn how to make reels. Jonathan is going to encourage me with his tips to do reels. So that would be interesting. And probably if he will be able to encourage me to do reels, he will be able to encourage you, because trust me, I'm way more stubborn than you. So, you know, now let's come to authenticity. And that's an interesting subject in this domain, because as you said, the first aspect about reels, most of the people, they think like this is pointing here and there, some transition, some playing, pretending that you are happy when you are probably not happy after 38 takes. I mean, we all been there. And that's why real really not stands for real. It's actually real. So it's like, you know, it's a different origination of this kind of name. So we know that it's not real. but it can be real, and you've proven it. You say that you've given this live video approach. So, and I also know at the same time, three things, and probably I'll be long in this situation because I know you, and I want to craft this question in such a way that it will encourage people to understand, first of all, the authenticity on camera, and on the second part, take your course. So, think number one. At the beginning, when I met Jonathan and he joined my course on Visibility Gym Challenge, he was like really not camera person. He was behind the camera, but not on camera person. He hated camera. Mm-hmm. Now, in the course of few visibility challenges, he became quite a star of like live video, to be honest. So that changed dramatically. There was psychological change and all the things. As I said, video somewhere there in the corner, check it out, hold the story, amazing. Now, then you denying the archetypes. And that's my personal thing because I'm teaching that. And now you're teaching archetypes, so it's okay. But you also present your alter ego in your reels, and that's what I want to talk about as well. And I also know Jonathan, who is like really hardworking expert, who is waking up now at 5 a.m. to learn and to work hard and harder and like everywhere on Clubhouse and like working. A person who really doesn't care about camera. If you put cameras all around, he will be like, yeah, this transition, whatever. I mean, this is like, you know, Gary Vee kind of approach. So you like totally real in that part. It would be probably interesting to put you on camera in these working processes. So
yeah, go on, yeah.
So we're talking about the three different Jonathans. And that's an interesting aspect of authenticity. Jonathan, who are you? That's my question.
Who am I? Well, you know, and that's a really funny question for a lot of reasons. One, obviously, this would not have happened before a visibility gym. There's no way in heck I would have sat here and been interviewed. And this week I've done three podcasts on video. This is very unusual for me, but there's much more comfort on camera, obviously, since the visibility gym. So there's that aspect of it. Then there's me showing up as myself, and I am very much showing up as myself. Now, you know, myself is a little bit, I got my blazers on it, but that's me. That's me. So people are like, are we sure that's himself? And then there's my alter ego, Becky.
Oh, hey, my name is Jonathan Howard, and I'm the owner of Success on Social. And what I do is help you show up on social media. You're saying that's easy, except you're the same person that refuses to show your face on camera. I can help you identify why you're struggling showing up and build the practices necessary for you to show up confidently and consistently for yourself and your business.
Sure, there's a lot of theory and stuff behind it, but what it really boils down to is you taking simple daily actions to move you closer to your goal.
I'm excited to help you start showing up. The question is, are you ready to start showing up? I think he is.
About those reels, I don't dance, I don't point, I'm not gonna do them. There's no way. Mm-mm. I know that I can talk a tip to camera and stuff, and it works the same as any other reel. I'm a little bit more comfortable doing that, but I am not gonna be pointing, and I'm certainly not gonna be dancing.
She is lovely. She's me with my voice sped up a little bit and a towel on my head. And it's hilarious because she is absolutely me. Mm-hmm. And she's playing the role of my ideal customer, which it's very funny because every single one of my clients is like, oh my God, you made Becky about me. This is something that I went through. And one, that's incredibly powerful. And if you can do that with something, that's a big win. So I'll take that as a win whenever anybody says that. But two, she's not based on any of them. She's based on me. Mm-hmm. Based on my struggles, the things that I've gone through. Yes, in a crazier, you know, underwater weddings, but she's still based on me and all of my struggles and everything that I suffered through, going through visibility and authenticity and showing up and learning reels, all of that. So she is equally me as I am as, you know, the person before, just going through different things. And as we grow, we can show that and we can let people see, just take a peek inside and see what's happening. And that's, you know, the transformation is powerful. When people see that transformation, it's really powerful. And I have been trying to share as much of it as possible when I'm doing this, because there's a lot of people that are afraid of showing up on video. There's a lot of people. And I know that feeling, so I can help them.
Fantastic. What do you think is easier for you, to show up as professional Jonathan, to be that person who hide in or whatsoever and just say like, yeah, I want to sleep, whatever. I'm not going to show up. I'll be Becky.
I would say being me right now is the easiest. Mm-hmm. Becky requires a little bit of thought because it's me in the past. And, you know, sleeping's always good, but you got to show up.
So what do you think? Will you invent some other alter egos, or what is the next step?
There's some other alter egos. There's some other alter egos out there that are, they're in the works. Because Becky can only go so far. But I would say there's going to be a lot more storytelling and characters in my reels as I need to develop that aspect of it. And I try to develop it actually with all my students as well. Mm-hmm. In the challenge that we do, is kind of their goal is by the end to be able to be their ideal customer. And that's kind of how it's written out.
I love it. Absolutely love it. And I absolutely encourage people to join Jonathan's challenge, because it's very interesting. Like when you go with your own journey. And I know that, you know, I think it was one of the first experiments when you were doing it, the character in life video. You remember it was one of the final videos on Visibility Gym. Mm-hmm. And we were creating the live sequence. Basically, it's exactly what you do, just like in a much shorter time. So you were doing transitions and like it was a lot of experiments. And I'm not just proud of you, I'm inspired by you, because you do a lot of things which people don't even think to do, because they following what other people do, and you teach the people think outside of the box, which is fantastic. And I would encourage people to follow teachers who teach thinking outside of the box, not giving you the fish, but teaching you how to catch the fish. So that's a correct teachers for you, and Jonathan, one of them. So totally.
Well, thank you.
Let's dive then, as I introduce you and already advertise you. You see, I'm excited. So now teach me how to do reels. Encourage me.
So what I always start with is that reels are short form video. Mm-hmm. And the goal is to get a very big topic, because reels go to your, it goes to your people that don't follow you. So your customers that, your ideal customers that don't follow you is pretty much who they go to, because they go out to just everybody pretty much. If you use the right, well, we're not using hashtags so much anymore, but if you use the right keywords and all that on Instagram, it'll go to the right people. So you want to create reels about the big ideas of your business, because it's top of funnel content, and it should be quick, easily digestible, and move them forward. Mm-hmm. So those are three important things. And you've got 8 to 12 seconds to do all of that. Mm-hmm. So what you do, and I'll give you the format that I always teach everybody, is that first 2 seconds, you've got to grab their attention. What is it that you're going to be sharing with them? How is it valuable? You're not going to be starting. Guess what? We're not going to be starting with, hi,
My name is Jonathan.
Yeah. Doesn't make sense for 3 seconds video, yeah.
Nobody cares. They don't care about who you are until you can help them.
Yeah.
So, you know, so what is it that they are going to get out of this video? And then you've got about 3 to 5 seconds to talk about that value. And then you've got about a second and a half, maybe, to end with a call to action. Mm-hmm. What is it that you want them to do after they watch that video? And that's the format for every single reel. And if it goes longer than that 8 to 12 seconds, you just got to add some more scene switches, some more engaging stuff that keeps them watching. Because the goal is to get them all the way to the end of the video.
Mm-hmm. And what do you feel in terms of timing? Like, you know, when people drop off, or there is no such things like people dropping from reel or something. So in terms of analytics, how does that look? When is the best time for call to action?
So that call to action, usually you can put it mid-reel. Mm-hmm. It may be, if you're going long on your reel, it may be worthwhile to do it mid-reel. But if you can get your reel to 12 to 20 seconds and you've got them engaged at the beginning, mm-hmm. then you're in good shape. If you get them in that first 3 seconds, you then have about 5 to 8 more seconds. So you can get that amount of content in and close it out. And you don't need to talk about 5 different things. You need to talk about one thing and just give them the idea, and they can get more in the caption and then on your feed, because you're going to get them to follow from the reel. That's the goal. So your call to action is generally follow, like, and follow for more tips.
Mm-hmm.
Because
the good question about this, sorry, I interrupted you, but the point is, you remember we were discussing music? Mm-hmm. And if you use the music from Instagram, technically you can't use it any place or something like that. So what if I prepare the video, like, and I can then use it as shorts, I can use it as TikTok, I can use it like this without the music, and then I can add music, like different type of music in there. I mean, unless I'm dancing with the storytelling, I think it will work, right?
With the storytelling, it works. And most of my videos I have downloaded without any music behind them. It's just me talking.
Perfect.
And then you can use them in multiple places. You can put it on TikTok, any of that.
And that's a tip for repurposing, guys.
And the pointing ones are great for repurposing, because guess what? You can point to different words.
Correct.
You can just record a video where you're going 1, 2, 3, and those 3 words can be different. You put a different filter, it looks like a whole new video.
And you can create a content library with a different show ups, and you can do all this kind of thinkings and just combine like tremendous amount of videos with the same point in you, just like re-edit it in a different way.
Yep.
Wow.
Yep. Put a new filter on it. You're done. Yep. I did that last year, right around my birthday. This is because people were telling me I couldn't repurpose reels. I was like, watch me. So I put a video Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. On Monday, it got 3,000 views. On Wednesday, it got 6,000 views. On Friday, it got 9,000 views. Same video, just switched it up.
Wow. Did you change filter or just put the same one?
I changed the filter, changed the words. One of them was flipped in the other direction. But because reels don't go to your audience directly, they go to non-followers, nobody knew.
Wow. That's phenomenal. And what is the keyword strategy? Do you use any keyword strategy for that?
Keep your keywords focused on your content. The people that are incredibly successful at reels, and those people that you see showing up and getting millions of views, they talk about one thing. They create reels about one thing. They use that one keyword and they beat it to death.
Mm-hmm.
And those are the people that killed it on reels. Those are the people that came over from TikTok and had, you know, these ideas, and they just stuck with one of them. If you're just starting your account, niche down way tight. Talk about that one thing. Get people engaged on that one thing. And then later, in a year or so, you can expand out. But get that audience really, really engaged. Get those 20,000 followers. And then grow with that in different ways.
And the content strategy, like, what do you feel is more successful? Just go reels, 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 or mix them with some other pieces of content?
So I think that you should mix it up with other pieces of content. If you're starting your account, I would say you can go 80-20, 80% reels, 20% non-reels, but you need value on your feed because reels are getting people into your ecosystem.
All right.
But your feed is where you're building that trust and that expertise. So you have to go deeper on your feed. So a lot of times you'll notice I'll have a reel and then I'll have a carousel that's about the same exact thing. It's just going deeper and giving them more insight. So I attract them with one, then there's that carousel with the other. So they build that trust and there's more value on the feed.
And what about stories? Like, can you add the stories to this strategy somehow?
Yep. Oh, absolutely. So the way that I build it, stories are bottom of funnel. Because that's where your super fans are. Those are the people that are willing to buy your stuff. Those are the people that are interested in what you have to offer because who else is going to go to your stories and see what you're eating for dinner? So honestly, your stories is where you can sell. So you're building that trust on your feed and you're selling in your stories.
So you just told me something which nobody told me before, honestly. But I mean, I was not probably in that subject as much because I ignored reels as long as it possible. Didn't have time for them. So first, you told me that you can make reel in 15 minutes, which with that idea of the storytelling, I can believe and repurposing, I can see how it can be done. So yeah, you sold me on that. You know, 15 minutes sounds way better than, like, you know, 2 hours.
Yep.
Now, you also gave phenomenal strategy on the fact, which I never heard before, honestly, the fact that reels go to the audience, which is unprepared, the cold audience, that the other parts of content in the middle in your feed basically services new people to prove the level of value which you deliver, and then the story cater the content to the super fans. That's gold, people. That's how you understand the content strategy on social media. That's gold, because when you understand who is buying, how many people you need to attract, how many people you need to get at this part of content, this is when you start setting up your metrics and measure your content and get money. Wow, Jonathan.
Yeah. And I will tell everybody, and I'll give you this tip as well. Don't focus on the views, focus on the engagement. How many people are commenting? How many people are you starting conversations with? When you focus on that, your content is directed towards those people, you're going to do much better, much quicker.
Mm-hmm. And how do you create this strategy in terms of the commenting and following up, for example? Because I know you are not the person who like popping up in somebody else's cold DMs or whatsoever.
Yeah, I'm not a big fan of the cold DMs, although if you've got them in through your stories, then you can DM them. So once you've engaged them in your story, then you can DM them because they're already DMing you. So it's not a cold DM.
Exactly.
And two, asking them to like and follow for more tips gets them into your ecosystem. They're going to then see some more stuff. They're going to naturally comment. And asking, obviously, for the comment in your caption. So mm-hmm. I often ask, which one of these reels will you be starting, you know, doing this week? What are you planning on doing? You know, easy questions first, get easy answers, and then you can start the conversation in the comments.
Mm-hmm. I love it. So get back to reels. When we talk about reels, which reels work the best from your perspective?
From my perspective, if you're looking for the engagement, talking head reels, my favorite is the walk and talk. Mm-hmm. You're going to do some trending reels to get some eyes on you, but you want to make that trend your own. So you've got to figure out a way to, you know, uniquely frame the reel so that it is your own. I give a lot of examples of the trends and how to make them your own. And I'll just do like remixes of some of the trends and I'll tell you, you know, like, make sure you do this, don't do this. You don't want to just do a dance to do a dance because it's trending. Mm-hmm. You want to use that video to at least teach something.
Yeah, I can. I mean, personally, I saw, I subscribe to a few people, not on Instagram, to be honest, but shorts working in a very same way on YouTube.
Yep.
So I subscribe to a few people through shorts because I could see that they have so much more sense, you know, with this very, very short timing. I'm like, I imagine how much they can give in a longer video. So it does make sense for me. And yeah, I absolutely agree that we make customers, not just viewers. Yep. When we deliver the content. So as long as we were talking about customers, I still understand that we need to spend some time to create reels. And to be honest, when you are an entrepreneur, time is a big thing because we have calls, we have discovery calls, some of us have work. So how to minimize this time for reels? Tell me more about that.
So one of the things that I have actually is 9 reels that you can create in 15 minutes or less, but you have to follow the take three policy and you'll be able to get those reels done. So my take three policy is you get 3 takes. That's it. One of them has to be good enough. Treat it like live video, like Eve says, but I have the 9 reels that you can create in 15 minutes or less. Wow. And I think honestly, they're 9 formats that are really easy to do, and you can get them done in 15 minutes or less. Actually, I do most of them in 5 minutes or less.
Mm-hmm. What are these formats? Some of them, of course.
So, well, one is the intro video. You have to do an intro. You got to let people know who you are, what you do, and why it matters to them. And you can do that repeatedly, actually.
Yeah, how often do you post the intro? Exactly the question.
So I post an intro usually once a month, actually.
Okay.
So I post an intro. I do all of these at least once a month because I run them in my challenge as part of what we're doing. So I've got that one. I got the talking head, which is literally just talking a tip to the camera. The walk and talk, which is the step up from that. It's kind of the advanced level. And then what I call the longer tutorial. This is one where you can actually do a little bit more. Maybe having something going on a green screen behind you so there's more engagement, more things happening. Mm-hmm. There's that. Then there's the pointing reel, of course. Everybody loves the pointing reel. there is the day in the life, which is one of my favorite ones. Mm-hmm. Day in the life, there is, what else we got in there? We got the look and react. So it's kind of like the pointing reel, just...
Mm-hmm.
Looking and judging whatever is on the screen. What else do we have? We have your character reel, which is one that can be done in 15 minutes or less. And I think I hit a bunch of them. I don't know which one I'm missing now. But you can grab all 9 of them. Mm-hmm. If you actually follow me on Instagram, hey, look. Yeah. And the link in my bio on Instagram has actually the 9 reels in 15 minutes or less.
Fantastic. So... obviously, how to connect with you, you have Instagram account, and it's very, very logical. And I encourage people to see what kind of reels you do, because I remember when we discussed your first reels, you asked me like how to make it mine. And we were talking about your amazing photos, the colors which you use and all the things. And ever since, you like totally merge with these beautiful photos and reels, and it's all you, like you is you and all the things. So I really, really love it. And what your suggestion is about that style, about the brand part of reels, especially because of that, I want to ask you, was that important or not? Because you are also branding experts, but more on the social media. And we discussed by that time that everybody were looking kind of same, and you wanted to give that extra vibe, that extra recognizable branding aspect. Did that work? Does it work to build the brand, like really recognizable branded style for your reels?
For me, it definitely worked. It's what people recognize about my reels. It's what people ask about. They're like, how do you do all of these? They all have the same energy. They all have the same color. They all feel the same. So for me, it worked. I think there's aspects of it that people need to put into play on their own account. Some aspect of it so that people, because you always want to create content that goes back to, oh yeah, that looks like something Eve would put out. Oh yeah, that looks like something Jonathan would put out. And that when they can see that, then they, my reels stop them all the time because they see it and it's different and they know it's me.
So the question is as well, you know, the dressing, undressing, redressing kind of reels. We were discussing this aspect that people who, stylists and people like that, they were very, very successful with first reels. What trends are actually popular, actually bringing you engagement? As we were talking about, you say the engagement is more important. So which trends make sense to follow for now?
There are very few trends that are going to get you engagement, honestly. There's very few trends that are going to get you engagement, but if you want to do what I always suggest, that was one of the reels that I left out, is the, you know, making a trend your own. So if you are able to take a sound that is happening right now and twist it to serve you and provide value in doing it in some way, then that's going to be a trend that'll work for you. But it's really hard. Most people watch trends and swipe. They see it, they see it, they see it. What? How many times can you watch the same video of them dancing to the same song? So it's not entertaining, honestly.
Exactly.
You have to either be the best dancer in the world or you have to make it unique for yourself.
Exactly. So do you think you can combine the trend with whatever dancing kind of thing and with the tips? I know that you tried that. So how did that work?
It works. It works sometimes and other times it doesn't. It's the thing with reels is sometimes you just got to put it out there. 20% of my content on reels is always experimental. I'm trying something new. I'm trying something different. I'm trying a new sound or whatever it may be because you've got to test on reels. There's so many variables that you just don't always know. So you do what you do know. What you've figured out is working for you. You create more of that, but then you experiment with some of the other stuff.
I love it. I love it, absolutely. So thank you so much for this interview because I already processing the information which you're giving me. I have no question. Processing started. Sorry, guys. You know. We already processing information, going to do some reels. I recommend you to do some reels and connect with Jonathan, because if you feel that you're hesitant, if you feel that you don't know how to create reels, the technical aspect of that, to be honest, I've been in your shoes because I started creating some reels and stuff like that. I don't understand anything. I'm like, okay, I will spend half an hour just understand it. I don't have half an hour. Okay, swipe. I'm doing something else. So that's exactly the situation for many people. They know they need reels and it is still trend, but they're like, yeah, whatever. It will take yet hours and hours and hours. I will not have time to master it. I don't want to dance. I don't want to feel stupid. I don't want to perform. I'm not a trained performer. Whatever kind of ideas you have in your mind, I'll encourage you to talk to Jonathan, because first of all, he had this journey from, you know, how to move from complete hatred of camera to perform like God of Reels, of real reels. And it's really interesting because he is really looking for all these trends and things which are not working and remove those from the palette, and he will tell you what works, what doesn't. So I will recommend you to follow Jonathan, to join his program, to at least follow him, his reels on Instagram and listen to his tips. And thank you so much for this interview. It was really, really interesting and as usually packed with wisdom. Thank you so much, Jonathan.
Thank you so much for having me. It was a pleasure.